live, AT&T says every customer is back online tonight. It comes after tens of thousands of people noticed their phones weren't sending or receiving messages starting overnight. AT&T acknowledged the interruptions. Both Verizon and T-Mobile say their service never saw any issues. AT&T's Global Network Operations Center is looking into that situation. And the outage led to, of course, many speculations about the potential cause.
Yeah, we still don't know why tonight. CBS 4's meteorologist Ethan Rosuck joins us now with one reason we can rule out. Hi, Ethan.
Hi, Bob, Aaliyah. And I just want to emphasize here, I took two astronomy classes in college. That's the extent of my astronomy knowledge here. Nonetheless, though, we still use a lot of these things when it comes to weather prediction and weather forecasting. But I want to debunk a rumor that was circulating throughout most of the day. There were solar flares. Three of them occurred overnight, the latest one being right in the middle of the spectrum for R1 to R5. These were radio interferences. The biggest one was an R3. So it was not the biggest, but kind of in the middle of the pack here. And these solar flares are an eruption of the sun's energy. We've seen these before, and we're going to see more of them in the years ahead here because we're near a solar maximum with what we're calling it here. And I first want to talk about this. This occurred 3 hours before the first outage reports came in here. It recorded the flare at 1:30 this morning, I should say, and it hit the radio frequencies, the HF frequencies, not the UHF, the ultra high frequencies where cell phones are on. So that's why these flares couldn't have been accounted for when it comes to the outage today. Not to mention it was nighttime here, and these types of flares occurred in the daytime on the other side of the world. That's where it was felt because these were radio interference coming from the solar flare. That's why we didn't get anything directly from the solar flare. Nonetheless, though, it's always a good reminder that if you do have cell service that gets disrupted, kind of like what happened with AT&T customers today, you have multiple sources you can have handy when it comes to getting weather info here at the Weather Authority, your outdoor sirens, always having a weather radio. You can also use weather apps with Wi-Fi or subscribe to those wireless emergency alerts, and those come on a different frequency than any radio or cell phone frequency. So a little tidbit here, but no, the solar flares are not to blame with this, guys.